It's Blaze and welcome back to my channel. Today is day 19 of my 31 days of Halloween and I am showing you how I've decorated my altar for sewing. So before I get into this video, huge apologies for A, my super cashness. I've been so busy today, mostly with uni work, so I've not had time to do a full face, so apologies for that. Also apologies for the camera angle, it's a bit of a mess and the pumpkin's just roaming about in the background, and also Jake is in the other room watching TV, so if there's a lot of background noise I apologise for that. But let's just get right into it. I don't want to keep you guys for too long, this is just a short simple video. So I'm just going to talk you through like the main things I've got on my altar and why, and hopefully this will give you a bit of inspiration on how to decorate your altar for this Sabbath. And if you have decorated your altar, like especially for sewing, please 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 tag me in it. I would love to see it. I'm just obsessed with altars, they are just so pretty. So let's just get into it. So first off, this altar cloth. I've had this altar cloth since I first set up my altar like 2-3 years ago. It's just a thing from Poundland, that's all. It does fit with sewing because it's a little bit spooky, but I just keep it on all year round. Anyways, I am in the market for a new altar cloth. If anybody knows anywhere that is good for altar cloths, then please let me know. So I guess we'll just start with the main things on the altar. So we have a jar of bones here. Some of these are chicken bones from like a chicken carcass from a roast dinner, and some of these are from ribs like in a restaurant. I used to work in a restaurant and I would collect the bones and hide them in my pocket and then take them home and clean them up and stuff, so I have those in there, and I thought they'd be good decoration for this time of year, for the kind of like death and life cycle and stuff, so just keep those on there. I have this pumpkin wax melter from Yankee Candle, and Jake got this for me for Christmas last year, and obviously it's good because it's a nice sturdy proper wax melt, so you can pop your tea light in there and then melt wax on the top, so this is a good alternative to candles. Well, I guess you still use a candle, but you know. Then I have these two candles here. These are both from Tiger, and I showed these in my cheap Halloween, which I uploaded, I want to say it was yesterday, but possibly the day before, I don't even know anymore. And the sole reason I have these, obviously, who doesn't use candle magic, but also they are the right colours for sewing, and I think they just look really cute on the altar. Next up, I have a crystal ball. Because of the veil between the spirit world and our world is thinning, it is a great time for divination, so I have a couple of divination tools included on my altar. A, they're good for decoration, and B, obviously to use. This crystal ball, I believe, I got from eBay, and I've had that for a good couple of years. Next up, I have my tarot deck. Again, good for divination. I have the Anne Stokes collection, and again, I believe these were from eBay. These are the only tarot cards I've ever owned. They come in this box here. I would love to get my hands on some vintage tarot. So again, if you have any recommendations, please let me know. Then have my pendulum. So it's black, I think it was onyx on the end. And I got this from Spooky Box Club in the Mystic Box. So again, because it's a great use or a great form or tool for divination, then it's great for using around sewing time, and also the black matches the colour scheme for sewing. I then have a picture of my granddad here. Unfortunately, I never got to meet him. He passed away before I was born. But sewing is a great time for remembering loved ones who are deceased, who are no longer with us. And as I said, it's a great time to contact spirits and things. So they are a great way to decorate your altar. Then I have a little sparkly pumpkin, and this was from Poundworld for £1.50. I just thought it'd be a nice little piece of decor. Then I've got my chalice. This features on my altar year round. It's just obviously used in ritual or ceremony or whatever. I'm pretty sure I picked this up from a charity shop. I then have my little ceremonial dagger. I picked this up from a car boot sale. It is technically a letter opener, I believe, but I think it's pretty cool as a little dagger to direct energy and things. So again, that's used in ritual, so that's kept on my altar year round. Then underneath my altar, so that I can grab it when need be. Oh my god, this is so heavy. Oh, it is a big cauldron, and then it has the little three moons on there, and this is so fucking heavy. Oh my god, I bought this from my local witch store for, I think it was £25, but the lady gave me a discount because she's so lovely. And I've used this in a couple of spells, and I love working with a big cauldron. I do have a tiny little one that I got for Christmas a couple of years ago from my mum, but then I have upgraded to a big ass cauldron. But yeah, again, that's under my altar because A, it's very heavy, and B, I can just grab it out quickly when I need. Sounds like an emergency. I'm like, quick ritual. Then lastly, under here, I have this box full of my crystals. Again, this is kept near my altar year round because obviously crystal work is very, very useful. So this box I actually found from a charity shop, and it came with loads of weird little things in it. Not weird as in like, oh, that's really cool, just like little cheesy ornaments and stuff. I think I threw most of them away. But yeah, the box was really, really cheap, and I saw it and I was like, that is going to be perfect to store my crystals in. So most of these are, or have been, handed down to me from my mum. So as you can see, there's quite a few, and I am always collecting more. Some of them are taken out at the moment because they're being recharged or cleansed. So yeah, I try to keep them in colour order, but my life is very chaotic, so as are my crystals. So yeah, I keep those right under my altar for ease. That's pretty much it for this video. I just wanted to do a little quick introduction to my altar, show you what I have, and show you how I've decorated it for sewing. Had I had more time and more money, this would be very extravagant. However, this is all that I am able to do at this current time. Yeah, so that's it for this video. If you have any questions, please pop them down below, but do remember I'm not the most advanced and magical witch, so I may not be able to answer your questions, but I can give it a good go or direct you to someone who can. Yeah, so like I said, if you do decorate your altar for sewing, please tag me in it as I'd love to see it. And thank you so much for watching, and join me tomorrow for more spooky content. Bye.